In 1989, a show would premiere that would forever change the face of broadcast journalism. That show, of course, was Hard Copy. But in the same year, in this studio, in a high school tucked away in the small Los Angeles suburb of Los Feliz, a handful of students would make some news of their own.
Hello, and welcome to the first production of Marshall High's Campus News. I'm Steve Gligoroff, along with Philip Ezeroff and Min Luong, here to present the latest in sports, news, and entertainment updates.
The date was March 10th, 1989. The show was Campus News, and this show is about how far it's come in its first 10 years. And I'm just one of nearly 250 people who've been fortunate enough to participate in this unique program. For the next few minutes, we'll be looking back on 10 remarkable years of Marshall history as chronicled by the young people of Campus News. But first, let's go back to the very beginning and find out just how Campus News came to be. In 1981, the new science building at Marshall was completed. In addition to classrooms, the library, and the cafeteria, it also housed the media center, which was designed to provide and maintain audiovisual equipment for the school. The media center also had video facilities to be used for class activities and video projects, and a small group of media service students were trained to operate the equipment. Eventually, the class turned into a production class where students wrote, shot, and edited short films and video projects.
We experimented. We did some news, but we didn't broadcast it. Then in about 88 or 89, I said to the kids it would be great if we could broadcast to the whole school and give them, instead of a daily bulletin, a newscast. We took a table, put some blue jean cloth over it, denim cloth, and we actually broadcast our first show, Campus News, our first show. I can remember it now. It was awful. We used very, very basic equipment. And of course, you can see by some of the examples, we didn't know we need synchronization. We didn't know we need time-based correctors. We didn't know we needed meters, etc.
The UCLA had a strike vote, and of the teachers at Marshall High who voted, an overwhelming 94% authorized the union to strike.
The first show was a disaster. We didn't have the little red tally lights that would tell us which camera to look at. And then they didn't have intercom systems or PL lines, so you would hear one intercom, and I would sit there, and you know, three people would be talking at once, and I'd hear camera one, and I'd like look at camera one, no, we're not talking to you, so I'd look this way, and it's horrible. And then after only a couple of weeks, Harley decided, hey, we're gonna do the show live, and that was even worse. It was so much fun.
Despite that rough first episode and the teacher strike of 1989, three more episodes of Campus News would air that school year. By the following fall, Campus News had already become a Marshall institution.
Come to school and ask the question, who is your favorite music group?
Led Zeppelin, because it makes me feel good. My Natural High. U2, because they're like There were four people before, there were four musicians, and they have like a message, and they're not into blondes or anything, and the music.
It's OVA because it's good kickback music.
So as you can see here at Marshall High, there's a great diversity for musical taste. As for me, I like a band called Rush. I'm Carl Morrow, reporting for Campus News.
I promise it will make you laugh. I'm so sure it will, I give Christmas Vacation a thumbs down. Oh, I mean a thumbs up.
Each succeeding year saw an improvement in the quality of the show. Equipment donated by ABC or purchased through grants made the show look better. Professionals from the field of broadcast journalism shared their knowledge and experience with the class, and the show itself would continue to evolve.
Have a rockin' summer and a great life. And we're out of here. Amen.
Good morning, barristers, and welcome to the first edition of the all-new Campus News for 91. You may have noticed many changes. We think they're good ones, and we hope you'll agree.
CN12 and the rest of the Marshall community were upset and disheartened 2 weeks ago as violence broke out in our city. Now that things have settled down somewhat, the artists and musicians here at Marshall have banded together to raise money and gather supplies for the riot victims.
I want to be on Blossom's family because she is fine.
I would love to be a member of the Brady family, because if I were Jan's brother, I would slap her face so hard for whining so much.
I would like to be a part of the Simpsons.
Starting in 1993, Campus News wasn't just for the campus anymore. Century Cable, which serves hundreds of thousands of homes in Los Angeles, put Campus News on its public access schedule. Not only did Campus News give people a peek at the goings-on in Marshall, it also became a source of news and information about the community for the community.
Now for this week's Campus and Community Roundup, we have Kelly Corrales. Kelly.
Thanks, Danny. The Echo Park Improvement Association is holding a graffiti paint-out and street cleanup event on Saturday.
Hello, viewers, and thanks for tuning in to John Marshall High School's Campus and Community News, bringing you the latest from
Campus News finally hit the open airwaves in 1997 when it was added to the lineup of programs on KLCS, the LA Unified School District's television station. Now everyone in LA can tune in to Campus News every week.
And when we finally caught them, Mr. Kadani had only one thing to say.
He's going to clean up the whole section right here, okay?
Campus News has been there to cover some of the more interesting and exciting events in Marshall and LA history. Here are some of the famous faces and unforgettable events that our cameras have captured. Not everyone who's graduated from Campus News has gone on to a career in the broadcast industry, but they can all agree that they've come away with a few good memories and a lot of good friends.
I mean, when I was in the ninth grade, I would turn on, you know, they would turn on the TV during second period and I would see Campus News, and wow, the anchors when they were up there, they just looked so great to me and they did their job so well that I was like, man, one day I want to do that. You know, I really want to do that.
What I remember from the class is just having a good time and not really knowing what I was getting into, but somehow it's stuck with me. It's something that started out as an interest or as a hobby is pretty much guiding my entire life now.
We get to get into the games for free. You just bring a camera, you can walk out of school for free if you just bring a camera. That's the raw stuff, man. You get to play on the internet for free. Get to do a lot of free stuff at Campus News.
This class gave me the opportunity to do things I've never been able to do.
I realized that I don't ever want to enter TV news. And I think that was the most vital information I ever learned.
I'm leaving campus news with a skill. You know, like, everybody wants to be an actor, everybody wants to be a director, but not everybody knows how to edit. And I can edit.
Campus news is like a good hammer. You know, if you use it wisely, you can build a house. Taking that class showed me that journalism was fun, and number two, I met a lot of really good people in that class.
The kids in Campus News are real interesting on how they develop their own social order.
A melting pot. I'm sure everybody's used that. It's totally, it's like a melting pot.
That was an interesting crew because, you know, we had such different people.
The kids are unpredictable. That's all I could say. I mean, I don't know, they must have some hormonal imbalance because one day they're really up high, you know, high from something, I don't know.
People fall in love, people hate each other, people get into fist fights, you know. But basically, people do a lot of bonding in there.
Not necessarily my drama, but like everybody else's, you know what I mean? In the back room.
When you get those whole romance things going on in Campus News, it just makes things hard for everyone else.
If you're on campus, people know you're in Campus News. It's like they respect you in a weird way.
Besides just learning and going to school, you can actually be a part of things, and it teaches you how the world works, at least in some small part. And that's what high school is really about.
It's fun. I think I'll always remember it, always cherish it. And I have 20,000 videos at home, so I don't think I'll ever, you know, forget about that.
The last take of the show, everybody's like, you know, get it together, get it right, we gotta go, I got something to do. But I mean, everybody's complaining about it, but when you really think about it, I think it's when we're having the most fun.
I'm really proud of what we did. I'm proud that, you know, we just got in there and said, okay, we're gonna give this a try. But even everyone in the school was supportive. You know, you'd get teased a little bit here and there, but for the most part, it was all good.
In the years to come, Marshall's Media Center will see new faces and continue to provide students with the opportunity to produce campus news for their peers and for you, our community viewers. As they carry on the privilege of being eyewitnesses and storytellers, so too will they carry on the grand tradition that Campus News has become. I'm Karina Gakkad. Thanks for watching. We'll be watching you. I got a warm, fuzzy feeling when I saw you on TV. You were wearing a piece of me. And it breaks my heart to look around and see the unimpressed who can't believe the emperor is dressed. Turn on my TV, I wanna take some action. If you got no video, well then folks don't wanna know. But with you up there to light the way, I can wear a smile as I survey their faces in the dark, waiting for you to hit one out of the park. When you see the real